Dear students, last time we have discussed about intermodule coupling. So that means that all of the modules should be independent and they should not be mapped or focused, or they should not be depending on each another. However, if they are sharing the same data, then that data should be passed using the parameters, or it can be defined as global. Today we will discuss more on cohesion, which means that one module should be cohesive. This means that that module should have only the instructions which are related to that particular module. So the term cohesion refers to this internal bindings, or in other words, the degree of relatedness modules' internal parts. So we were discussing in last module that if there is a function or module of student admission, and if there is a module of student examination, then in the instructions available in student examination module should belong to only that particular module. It should not be the case that within that module we put some other instructions which are related to student admission module. And similarly, in the module of student admission, we should write only those instructions which are related and relevant to student admission. And there should not be any statement or code line which is not related to student admission. So such a capability we should enhance in software engineering. So this is called that we need more intra cohesion within the modules. So the goal is that we should have low intermodule coupling. So between the different modules, those modules should be independent and they should not be depending on each another. And we should have high intra-module cohesion, that each module should be related and relevant and should solve only one particular problem. So there is another term known as logical cohesion. So this is the cohesion within the module induced by the fact that its internal elements perform activities logically similar in nature. So for example, we have written another module known as communication module. This communication module should only obtain data and should report data. So this communication module is the main module communicating with all of other modules. So as we have in our previous example, the game control module, which was the communication module that was dealing with the surf module, with the trajectory calculation module, with the update score module, with the return module, and so on. So this module should perform only this process or procedure. So we should not, or we cannot, put the instructions of return module within the control game module, which is the communication module. So there should be a functional cohesion as well, that all the parts of the modules are focused on the performance of single activity results. So it can be increased by isolating subtasks in other modules and then using these modules as abstract tools. So for example, if we are building a student examination module, so you can also think of some sub modules within that student examination module, and you should try to divide student examination module or any module into further small parts, and then those small parts should be considered as abstract tool to build the whole module. So if we conclude today's module, we have discussed about cohesion, its goal, logical cohesion and functional cohesion, and we have concluded in this module that there should be very high intra-module cohesion.